Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of German truck maker Daimler as it posted better than expected full-year earnings of over 5 billion euros. Daimler's chairman says while 2023 was a record year for them, earnings could be flat this year amid difficult economic conditions. Looking at Daimler shares, it surged by a significant 14%. A special focus also on the U.S. tech firm Dell, as a boost in demand for its artificial intelligence servers helped push fourth quarter revenues to $22 billion. The Texas-based company is looking at a very good start to the new month, with shares in pre-market open surging by 22%. And finally, shares of Italy's Leonardo climb as the defense group explores a possible joint venture with Germany's military sensor maker Hensoldt. Leonardo shares are higher by 2%, trading at 20 euros apiece.
Asian markets ended the first day of March mostly higher. Leading gains in the region is Japan's Nikkei 225, which surged nearly 2%. The Japanese index closed at an all-time high Friday, just 90 points behind the 40,000 mark. Chinese markets were also in the green as traders assessed the latest manufacturing data from the mainland. Meanwhile, South Korean markets were closed for a public holiday. Here at home, Philippine shares failed to join the regional upswing, falling 0.3%. It, however, managed to notch a modest weekly gain.
This week was really more profit-taking, no? At least people were able to make their profits, get their, you know, get upside. So I think maybe by next week the market should be recovering, okay. And then it will be testing already the 7,000 range. Especially if the inflation numbers, as you said, come out in the lower end, that's going to be positive.
The Philippine Securities and Exchange Commission inks a data sharing agreement with government agencies to boost efforts in combating money laundering and terrorism financing. The agreement will allow the SEC to disclose beneficial information about corporations to several government agencies. These include the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, the National Bureau of Investigation, and the Department of Justice. The SEC is hopeful the initiative will help the country exit the Financial Action Task Force's gray list of global money laundering.
All companies are required to submit their beneficial ownership. So, sino ba talaga ang mayari? Okay. So, of course, this is redacted, but there's no stopping us from sharing it from our fellow law enforcement agencies. We'll be able to share all this beneficial ownership information to them for purposes of taking enforcement action for money laundering.